Hi yogis. Hope you're doing well. Namaste. Good to see you. Or not see you, but virtually see you. Anyway, moving on to the second chakra. So this is a hatha, a little bit of vinyasa class. But the lower two chakras are primarily lower, slower classes, and then as we move up, we'll start generating more energy and more heat. So for those of you just now coming to your mat, getting back on your mat or starting your practice again, this will be great, a great place for you to start, okay? So the second chakra is right above the first, and it's called the sacral chakra. As you can see in the diagram right above me, it's located right where your reproductive organs are, okay? So this center is where we get our desire from and our creativity. And so if we feel stuck in that area, sometimes it's a really good way to open and free that energy. And it occurs mentally, so it actually happens to us in our mental state as we start to explore this region of the body, open it up a little bit. So let's close our eyes and just envision that space for a little bit. So I want you to go ahead and close your eyes and just sit up nice and tall, roll the shoulders back like we started with the first chakra. And so closing your eyes, tapping into your breath, letting your pelvis settle down. So envisioning the pelvic bowl now. So moving up a little from the root chakra, envisioning the pelvic bowl and all that it contains. Our reproductive organs lie there. And this part of the body is very watery in nature, so it helps for us to move the pelvis quite a bit to kind of generate more flexibility and bring about a sense of joy, actually, through movement of the hip and pelvis area. If you like to dance, you know what I'm talking about. When you go dancing and you start to move your body and your pelvis, moving your hips, that sense of joy that comes over you after dancing, especially if you haven't danced in a while, just brings back just a time of our childhood when we have a little bit more freedom. So we're just gonna bring a little more life into the pelvic bowl region. So envisioning this part of the architecture of the body that you're gonna be affecting today. So just take a couple more deep breaths here, just noticing if you feel rigid in this area. Like, do you feel rigid, tight? And let's see if we can do something about that. So let's go ahead and just open our eyes. And you're gonna take yourself to your back. So just bring your hands underneath your knees and you're gonna lower yourself down. And if you've had a long day, this is gonna feel really great, right? So just bring your knees into your chest and just feel the whole back body make contact with the floor. So just rock yourself side to side. Let the shoulder blades soften. Let the kidneys, which lie right above the low back, let them soften into the mat. Just kind of go back and forth. So what's interesting to discover through our yoga practice is that we actually have a pretty big impact on the organs of the body. So you're holding the knees into the chest and then rocking side to side. So massaging the kidneys and also the adrenal glands that lie there above the kidneys. All right, so just bring your feet to the floor, bring your palms to the floor, and let's just do some pelvic tilting here. So you're just gonna scoop the tailbone up, so your tailbone's gonna sort of reach towards your knees, and then you're gonna actually just lay it back down. So then you feel the curve in the low back come in. So you're gonna lift the pelvis, Tuck the tailbone under and then just release it back down. Let's do that a couple of times. So you're really just connecting to this part of your body. Just feeling the pelvic bowl and how it can actually move. And now we can tuck it under and then release it a couple of more times. This song, Waking Up Your Soul. This is great. So bring your knees back into your chest and let's do some circles. So you're going to take your knees wide. Your hands are on top of your kneecap. So take the knees in towards the chest, then bring them out and then back around. So what I really want you to think about is the fluid nature of the pelvic bowl region, the organs that lie there. How can we stimulate that fluid nature just a bit? This is how we can stimulate the second chakra, the sacral chakra. So just a couple more. And then change directions. So go the other direction. So you know what that means, right? So you're holding on and you're making the movement as big or as small feels good to you. So what feels good? And then just bring the soles of the feet together. Bring your hands around your ankles, your shins, or your feet, and draw your feet towards your chest. So pull the knees down, pull the feet down towards the belly or the chest. So you're feeling the inner thigh stretch here. So the second chakra governs the sex organs, the intestines, the inner thigh. So just connect to that part of your body right now as you're moving into the stretch and just allowing this to feel good. Good. Happy baby pose. So just go ahead and take the shins perpendicular up and down. Knees come wide of the ribs. So they're not over the ribs, they're actually wide. Flexing the ankles here and just letting the shoulders hang, right? So I actually want you to feel the inner thighs open just a bit more. And then you can pelvic tilt here too. So I want you to lift your tailbone up a little bit and then move it back down. So just up and down a couple of times. Nothing too aggressive, just a few times. Then soles of the feet come back together and you're actually going to bring them down to the floor. All right, so your knees are wide and this might feel a little awkward to begin with. Your palms turn to face up, crawl the shoulder blades underneath you for just a few breaths and just let the inner thighs open on their own. So there's going to be a lot of resistance here and you're going to feel the groin pulling the internal structure of the pelvis. So just see if you can soften that just a bit. So what that means is soften the gripping if you're feeling gripping there. So just let it go. And take three cycles of breath here. So nice inhale. And exhale. For those of you anxious to move, I promise you we will. So let's just spend some time here. Spend some time opening the hips and pelvis. Not that we can really open the pelvis too much, but the internal structure can release just a bit. So just letting go of the tendons, the ligaments, a little bit that support this structure. And then very gently just reach down and reach for the outer edges of your legs and just bring the knees back in. Let's cross our right shin over the left thigh. Draw your feet and legs towards you. Interlace your hands around your hamstrings and let's stretch the outer hip. So just, this is called Eye of the Needle pose. And I encourage you to move a little bit in your poses as well. So like here in this pose, you might rock your shin across the body a couple times. So just side to side while you're pulling. And just maybe noticing not to go too deep here because you're not really warm, but we're just kind of gently opening up this part of the body. Okay. And then from here, bring the feet back down, cross the left shin over the right, pick up everything, bring it towards you, interlace your fingers around your right hamstring, drop your shoulders back, and then just notice sensation. So you're trying not to be on your ankle here. You're actually trying to come across so the shin is lying on top of the thigh as best you can. And for some of us, our hips are so tight that it's really hard to do that. So see if you can keep your left ankle flexed for this pose, and that'll help to protect the knee joint. So notice that if you really relax your foot, you'll feel a tugging around the knee, and then if you flex your left ankle, you're gonna feel more support there, and maybe just the stretch, which is what we want. Soften the back body, soften your face. Just releasing those muscles that get so tight from sitting in chairs, driving in our cars in the traffic, and or chasing our kids around, whatever you're doing. And then just bring the feet back to neutral, scoop up the back of the knees, and rock your way up. Good. So from here, you're just seated, and so all you're gonna do is bring your right hand to your left knee. You're gonna sit up nice and tall, and just bring your other hand behind you. So left hand comes behind you, sit up tall, and just take a little twist. So just gazing over the right shoulder, pulling the navel in, so supporting the low back by using your abdominals. Breathing. Just letting this feel good. Good, and then slowly unwind. Inhale to center. Exhale, turn to the other side. So just a gentle twist, nice and easy. Gazing to the left. Pulling the abdominals in. Good. Then release. Swim yourself around to the other side. Let's plant our palms. Plant our palms. A few rounds of cat and cow. Knees underneath the hips. So inhale and look forward, drop your belly, tailbone lifts, and then exhale to round. Inhale, scoop the heart forward, really press into the mat. Exhale to round. One more time, inhale. Scoop, look forward, lift your chin, and exhale to round. Pull the belly in. Good, now let's rotate the hips here, so in some circles. So just doing what feels good. So really just circling. I'm going pretty big here. I know what my body's capable of. So just find your way into something that feels really good. So just like drawing circles with the pelvis. Change directions. So just really firing up the pelvis here, guys. Sacral area. Beautiful. And then from here, let's sweep our right hand up towards the sky. Look up towards your right hand. And then sweep it underneath, and let's take thread the needle here. So you're gonna bring the right side of your face to the mat. Pop your left fingers here like little spider fingers, and then just feel a nice shoulder stretch. And you can move in this too. So you can move your hips, sway your hips side to side. I want you to find the fluid nature of some of the poses. So instead of being really static, let's move a little bit and slowly rise. Right hand supports you as your left hand sweeps up. Feel some space across the chest and then sweep it under. Left side of the face comes down. Breath is steady. You could use the right fingers to push into the twist a little deeper if you want more. Keep steady breath here. Good, and then let's just go ahead and come on up. Bring the knees together. Sitting on the heels just for a few breaths. Roll the shoulders back. So maybe forward, up and back and down a couple times. Good, and now let's interlace our fingers behind us and really open the chest. See if you could start to straighten the elbows, bring the palms down towards the feet. Keeping the face nice and soft here, breath smooth. Good. Bring the hands forward. Let's move into downward facing dog. So tuck the toes, lift the hips up and back. Pedal out your dog, so bend your left knee and your right knee. So really paying attention to the lower body first. And spreading your fingers wide, rooting your palms into the mat. So feeling really the support that we talked about in the first chakra class of the base of the pose. What parts of the ground are touching. So the hands and feet are touching the ground right now, and so you want to feel really supported in your base. Good, and then let's rock forward to plank position. Hold the core in. Gaze forward a bit. Good, and then lower your knees. Untuck the toes. Let the chest move through. Roll the shoulders back. Scoop the heart up. Find your cobra. Up and back, downward facing dog. Walk feet towards the hands. Take a few breaths here. So remember, belly to thighs, knees can be bent here. Just let the arms hang, let the spine hang. Move in the pose, asking you to explore the fluid nature of the hips, and then slowly roll up. This part of the body can become really congested with stress and tension, so let's alleviate that a little bit. Let's move through some sun salutation. Inhale, sweep your hands wide and up. Exhale to bow, bend the knees, fold forward. Hands to the shins. Inhale to lengthen the spine. Exhale to bow. Hands to the mat. Step the left foot back. So same lunge we did before. Starting in your lunge, but then let your knees come to the mat. Shift your pelvis forward. Let's crawl up to the knee. Let's lift our heart, lift our arms, and see if we can stretch just a little bit. So if you're feeling too much in the low back, you back out, so you press through the right foot to come out. If you want more of a back bend, you shift your pelvis forward. Lift your gaze. If you need to stay here, stay here. This is okay here too. Shift your hands to the ground, step back to dog. Step your left foot between the palms. Right knee comes down. Untuck the back toe. Float your hands. Rise. So opening the psoas. All of these muscles that contain the pelvis. Keep it stable and steady. Let's loosen those a bit. And then bring your hands to the mat. Step back to plank. Engage your core nice and strong. Lower knees, chest, chin. This is modification for vinyasa. Those of you that are more advanced can go full up dog if you want. You choose. Good, lift the gaze and then pick the hips up and back for downward facing dog. Let's lift our right foot up behind us. Bend your knee. Draw some circles with the knee. So this might require bending your left knee just a little bit to help you feel more stable. But I want you to draw big circles with the knee if you can. Keep the navel pulled in. Good, and then drop the foot. Lift the left foot up behind you. Bend your knee and draw some circles. So again, noticing how the thigh bone rotates in the pelvis. Float the foot down, look forward, step to the top of your mat. Bowing. Hands come to the shins. Let's inhale, half lift and lengthen the spine. Straighten the elbows, gaze out, and bow. Press down through your feet. Inhale to rise. Press strongly, feel the base, the foundation of the pose, and then draw your hands to your heart. Let's go again. Inhale, rise. And exhale to bow. Hands to shins, inhale to lift and lengthen. This time stepping left foot back first for that low lunge. Knee comes to the mat. Again, option to stay at the knee or float your hands. Breathe in. Big breath to open the front of the spine. Float your hands to the mat, step to dog. Look forward, step your left foot between the mat. Right knee softens down. Inhale to flow your hands or stay at the knee here. You choose. Lift and lengthen. It helps to squeeze your butt a little bit to protect the low back. So notice that. So squeeze the right glute. Press through the left foot. That'll give you more stability. Bring your hands to the mat. Step to plank. Breathe in here. Breathe out to lower. Knees, chest, chin. Scoop your heart forward, shoulders down, elbows squeeze the ribs, then pick up the hips and move to your dog. Walk your feet in. Remember, usually when we move from a plank position, our feet are too far away from our hands for our dog. So you're in your dog, but you're just walking your feet in a couple of inches to shorten the stance. Beautiful. All right. Pick up your right foot behind you. Bend your knee. Open your hip to the side. Fill some space. Good. Then square the hip. Bring the knee towards your chest. Hug it in. Look forward. Step your right foot forward. You're in a lunge. Okay. Settling the pelvis down. Squeeze your left foot back a little bit. So you're in a long lunge. And now look at your feet. Your right foot is right in front of your right hip. And your left foot is behind your left hip. So there's a wide stance there. So that's your stability. You're going to actually rise up. Maybe help yourself to the thigh if you need to. And now you're in a higher lunge. Back leg is really straight. Arms extend. Breathe. Lift your gaze. Pull the navel in. Float your hands to the mat. Step to your dog. Left foot rises. Inhale. Bend the knee and open the hip to the side. Really press the mat away here. So really press away so you find the strength in your upper body. Square your hips, look forward, bend your knee, hug it in towards the chest, step it through. Now look down and check your feet alignment. Before you even come up, check your feet alignment, yes. So your back heel is right over the ball of the back foot. So back, right, the right foot, heel is right over the right toes, okay? Front knee is right over the ankle. And climb your way up, square your pelvis, and then send your hands straight overhead. Yeah. If this feels like too much for you, for your low back, you could just keep your hands by your side if you need to, do something less. And then just bring your hands to the mat. Step to dog. Good. Look forward, step your right foot between the hands again. Let's bend our back heel down and float ourselves up into warrior two. So we're just gonna kind of move here. So I want you to take a reverse warrior. So left hand to thigh, right arm reaches over, belly pulls in, nice and strong here. And then maybe gaze up towards the sky and keep bending the right knee. Yeah. Good. And then float your hands back to warrior two position here. And then we're going to actually turn our toes and move into our squat that we did before in chakra one. And let's just move our hips. So we're opening up to the side, arms to the side. So you're strengthening the upper body as you do this. And just shifting the hips. If you need to bring your hands to your thighs, that's good too. So just shift side to side. Remember, watery nature. Let's loosen up this part of the body. Beautiful. Back to warrior two. Breathe. Let the breath go. Straighten the right knee. Reach your torso. Let your right hand land. Left hand reaches to the sky for triangle. So nice and easy here. And let's just actually move the arm. Okay, so I'm gonna just make some circles here. So instead of being really rigid in my pose, my foundation is there. I'm thinking about how can I bring more movement into my body, which feels really nice. And then bend the knee, come back up. Breathe in, breathe out. Windmill your hands to the mat. Step to dog. Let's move through a vinyasa. So rock to plank, knees come down, untuck the toes, shift the belly, chest down, scoop your heart forward. Those of you that want the advancement, you do plank, chaturanga, up dog, and then downward facing dog. Good, look forward, step your left foot in between your palms, spin your right heel down, float your hands up to find your warrior two on the other side. So pause here and then reverse. Slide the right hand down, keep bending the left knee, keep reaching left fingertips over. Arm is as straight as you can get it. Good. And then float back to warrior two. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, straighten the left knee. Soft knee though, and then reach left hand out, float into your triangle pose, nice and easy. And just turn your gaze up briefly here. And let's churn just a little bit. So turning the arm in some circles. Good. And then just rise back to warrior two, breathe in. Breathe out, float your hands to the mat. Step to dog. Nice deep breaths here. Move through one more vinyasa to plank, to knees. Untuck the toes, chest comes through. Inhale to scoop your heart forward. Remember, elbows stay bent in cobra, okay? And then lower yourself down. Push back up. Move into child's pose, wide knee child's pose. Extend the arms.
And move your pelvis side to side. So what that means is I'm just kind of pressing my right armpit down, pressing my left armpit down. So when I press it down, my hips kind of shimmy side to side. Nice deep breath. And we forgot, well, we didn't really forget. We did got a squat on one side. But let's go ahead and walk the hands back here and do a squat at the back edge of our mat. So just take your feet wide, okay? Try to get your heels down, but that's not, you know, mandatory. In fact, you could roll up something behind your heels and have it there. If you have a block, you could sit on your block as well. Bring the elbows into the inner knee. Take your palms to your heart and just press the knees wide and just move. Let's move in this if you can, if that feels okay. Just side to side. Breathing. Yeah. Again, opening all of the structure, the muscular structure that holds the pelvis in place. Knee down. Right foot steps forward. Okay. So we're going to get in there. We're going to get into the pelvis today. So this is called lizard lunge. And if this bothers your knee, you could always fold your mat up and over to pad the knee a little bit. If you need more, or you've got a blanket or a towel or a pillow, you can slide it underneath the knee if you need that. I'm going to walk my toes out just a bit to the side. And support myself here on my hands. So I'm gonna make fists, if that feels better, if your hands bother you, to be on the hands. And then soften your shoulders down. Look forward. And enjoy one of the deeper stretches in yoga. Pretty deep. We're gonna see if we can go for a back foot clasp here. So I'm gonna plant my left hand, and this is optional. You could stay here. Or you can turn, revolve around, bend the back knee. So I have to sit my hips back to get my foot. I grab it and then I slide my pelvis forward. And now I've got a little quad stretch. And today it's really tight. I'm feeling a lot of tightness today, so I'm noticing that. I'm backing off just a bit. I don't need to go too deep here because I don't want to be too sore, okay? So just do what feels good. If you're really flexible, you just lean back into it. Good, and then release. Come back to your knees. Sit back on your heels. Let's open the quads here just for a breath or two. Noticing your breath as you move, so keep that steady inhale and exhale through the nose as much as you can. This is called the Ujjayi breath. Helps to calm the nervous system, keep the nervous system nice and quelled. Let's step the left foot forward now for lizard on this side. So I'm going to slowly make my way down. Maybe I have to stay up here, okay? Maybe I can bring my fingertips down. If you're in the studio, I have blocks here where I have people put their hands on blocks if the floor feels too far away. Unfortunately, we don't have that. You might not have that option. Yoga blocks are fairly expensive, so you can always pick some up. You know, I encourage you to do a home practice, you know, on your own. That's great. And then I'm going to firmly plant my right hand. I'm going to turn and look over my left shoulder. I'm going to sit my hips back. So I'm going to start to straighten this knee and then bend the right knee, capture the ankle. And this is a little more advanced. So if you cannot get it, this is okay. I have, you know, a few advanced yogis that are coming to class. So I like to be able to offer them a little taste of something deeper if they need it. And again, just know that maybe next time you come to your mat, bring something to cushion your knees if you feel
too much in the kneecaps. So a blanket is good, or a towel, like a beach towel, is great to roll up and place under your knees here. Let's release. This time, step to dog. Shake it out. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. Beautiful. Rock to plank. Knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. You know where you can go. Pressing into your cobra. Pressing back to child's pose. So now, for some of you, this might be too much. So maybe stay in child's pose for this. We're going to try something new. So we're going to keep our big toes together. Our knees are wide. And we're going to actually come forward and let the pelvis come down, the toes come up. We're going to hang in like a lifted cobra pose. So my toes are back and up, and I'm just hanging. Good. And then go back again. Reach the hands away. Beautiful. Come forward. Hang the pelvis, lift the chin, lift the gaze. Sit back. I'm going to bring my knees together, bring my hands by my side now. Just come off my hands all together. I'm just being in a closed-kneed child's pose. Rise. Knees walk forward, feet wide, straddling the left side of your mat perhaps, or wherever you naturally turn, doesn't matter. So just coming wide here, a nice straddle. So again, something to cushion your seat here might be necessary if it's hard for you to stay upright. If you feel like you're collapsing in your chest, that's how you know you might need something underneath your hips. Walk the fingertips forward, chest forward, let the gaze move down. Nice deep breath. So here you could rock the pelvis just a little bit too. So I'm just sort of tilting pubic bone towards the floor, and then tilting my sit bones back. Tilting my pelvic bone towards the floor, or pubic bone. Back and forth a few times. This is a good song too, if you guys can hear it. Makes me want to move just a little bit. Instead of just being really static, I'm moving. Good. Rise. Soles of the feet together. Hands at the ankles. Let's inhale and sit up nice and tall. So feel that lumbar curve come in. That's the low back curve. Feel it come into the back. That's natural. You want that. And then slowly tilt the heart forward. So nice and easy. Just melting here. Let your chin come to your chest now, and let's just release. Feel the desire to hang out in these kind of poses longer, but you need some encouragement to do that. So a stretch that goes a little deeper. The yin class is for you. It's an hour long of these types of poses that we just hold. We hang out, we stretch, It feels like you've gotten a massage, that's all I can say. You feel really relaxed when you're done, so I highly recommend it. And then slowly come up. Rock yourself back. Let's just windshield wiper the knees. So just nice and easy. I'm leaning back, windshield wipering. And then I'm actually gonna turn around to face this direction just so I'm not squaring your face with the middle of my body there. And I'm gonna straddle. So I'm gonna bring myself up and into a straddle. So just take yourself into this position. So you're on your spine. And we're actually gonna take our hands out to the side and we're gonna work our core just a little bit here. So you're just gonna let your legs come to the side. Let your right foot come to meet the left, back up, and then to the other side. So finding some stability in the core. Come back to center, let the left foot come down, and then with control, let the right foot come down. One more time, inhale back to center, lift up, let the right foot come down, and then the left. Let's just do that a couple more times. So coming back to center, left foot, right, slowly comes down and up, back to center, left, right foot comes down. Good. And then from here, just scooting yourself to your back. Bringing the feet close in. Let's take our hands and just rub the palms together here. I want you to create some friction between the palms. Maybe slide your feet out just a little bit, and then you're going to place them right on the hip flexors, the psoas. Just let your hands rest there for a few breaths. Nice smooth breaths here. Always noticing the energy shift a little bit. We call that energy shift the prana. Prana moving through the body. Reach up. Let's do it again. Palms rubbing. And then just on the pelvic region, bring your hands. So this is how we can sense subtle energy. If you have a question in your mind about what we're talking about when it comes to the chakras, like if this seems like a silly concept to you. You can feel the hands shifting, transferring energy to the pelvis right now. We're made up of energy. And through years and years of constant stress or life's ever-changing ebb and flow, we build tension in the body. Our yoga practice is designed to move and shift that energy. So one more time, let's bring our palms up. It's beautiful because it's an introspective practice. Bring your hands back down to whatever part of your body needs it right now. So I'm just bringing it back to my hip flexors. Just taking a couple more breaths here. Feel really good when we're done with practice or when we practiced in the past. Or perhaps we really haven't understood what we were doing and I'm just kind of moving through the poses, trying to get through the poses, trying to figure them out. What are we doing here? I really like the study of the chakras because we get to understand the energy system of the body and how it affects our ability to move out in the world. So the organs you're affecting here, the sacral area, our reproductive organs, part of our digestive system as well, is located here. Good. And then from here, draw your knees into your chest. Final twist. So extend your left leg straight. And let's just reach our right hand out to the side and cross the right knee across the body to the other side. Extend. And again, some really deep breaths here. This is the release. This is the release we need. So letting go. To center. Extend the right leg, left knee to chest. Right hand stays on the outer left knee as you roll onto your right side. Extend your left arm. Close your eyes. Noticing how the breath moves through the body. Really the key to some mental shift and change that starts to happen the longer you practice. Believe me, when I first started practicing, I thought, what is all this yoga stuff? What does it really mean? And then I started feeling amazing without really knowing what was happening and what I was doing, but I knew there was something that was happening. So I really embraced it. Good, and then slowly back to center. Extend both legs, palms turn to face up. And this is your opportunity to just let go. So closing your eyes. Closing your eyes, feeling a relaxation come across the entire back of the body first. So feel the bones settle, the bones of the body. Make your connection to the earth so we can continue to feel that grounded sense through the Shavasana practice itself. So let the breath expand as the body drops back. Eye sockets release their grip around the eye. Tongue softens in the mouth, the jaw, the throat, the shoulders drop back. Cool, subtle thing that happens to me, and maybe you'll notice this as well, is that when I get ideas come to me. New ideas, meaning the creativity that maybe was locked up somewhere, comes flooding out. I can feel more confident too, in that, confident in my creativity and what I want to do. It's like the self-doubt and the worry about making choices that I know I want to make become less of an obstruction. And there's this clear path that starts to reveal itself to me. So perhaps there's more clarity of thought that arises. Start to notice the physical changes, but there will be some emotional and mental that occur as well. So take notice. Good. And then you're welcome to stay here as long as you like. The beauty of the home practice is get to stay in Shavasana for 10 minutes. For those that cannot remain, perhaps you might need to start to bring some life back into the fingers and toes. Your eyes closed and keeping this meditative state just for a few more moments. And if you'd like to rise and come to your seat, go ahead and do that. As you come on up, just come to your seat, eyes still closed. Just draw your palms to your heart. Acknowledge your effort to get on your mat today, to be here practicing with me. Embrace your fluid nature. Embrace your creative nature. Namaste. Thanks for practicing with me.